All right, so in this funded trading community, what's talked about a lot is copy trading or trade copiers and looking for a good trade copier that's going to be appropriate with your system, especially if you're using Sierra Chart or if you're using multiple funded programs or multiple prop firms, you're trading with multiple prop firms. The challenge in that is they promote having multiple accounts and maximizing the potential that you can make with these funded accounts by using multiple accounts, which is a real thing, right? I've been able to significantly improve or increase what I've been able to do with my day trading by opening up multiple prop firm or funded trading accounts, right? Now, the challenge in that is trying to trade in multiple accounts at one time. So, one of the best solutions is to use a trade copier, right? And the problem with that is most of the trade copiers on the market do not work cross-platform. So if you're trading one account in NinjaTrader, and you got another account in Sierra Chart, and then let's say you got another account with that you're trading in multi-charts and so forth and so on, right? The problem that you have with these trade copiers is they don't integrate well with all of those different platforms at one time. The other problem is all of these prop firms, or most of these prop firms, they use Rhythmic for data. And with all of these trading platforms, you can only log in to the, especially with Sierra Chart and NinjaTrader and MultiCharts, all the ones that I use, you can only log in with one Rhythmic account at one time. So that creates a problem to where now, in order to be able to get the full benefit of these funded accounts by having multiple accounts, you're either going to be stuck with just using one firm, whether that's you just only trading with Lilu, or you're only trading with Earn to Trade, or you're only trading with Apex, and the list goes on and on, right? I'll put a link in the description below for different prop firms and different funded programs that I've used and I have experience with, okay? Now, what I'm going to talk about in this video is a solution to that problem and the solution that I found to be the best way to get around that whole problem, so where that I have different funded accounts with different brokers or different prop firms. Okay, so the solution that I use is by using a tool from this company, Mergi. I don't know how to properly say that, but it's mergi.com, Mergee.com. You just go there, and they have several tools, by the way. But the one that I use is the auto mouse click, right? Which is this one right here. It's simple, you just go and download it. And I believe before there might have been some sort of fee, but I don't really pay anything for it. So you just go through, you just download it, right? Click the download button, it'll come up with this setup. You can just open that right on up. The installation window will come up, and you'll just follow the installation all the way through. Now, of course, it's simple installation. I'm not going to go through it because I already have it on my system. So once you open up the Mergi Auto Mouse Click software, this is the window that'll pop up. And you see you have two windows. Basically, you have the main one, and then you have this other thing here. I just close that every single time. I don't use that. Now you can start configuring this right here, which, for me, it doesn't give me the functionality that I need. But let me explain what this does before I get deeper into it. So what this does is it uses hotkeys. You can set up hotkeys to where when you press that hotkey, it'll click your mouse on different parts of the screen where you tell it to, right? Now I can also do it just in random places, but we're trying to do this for trading, so we want to tell the mouse where to click on the screen, right? So the way that I use it is I open up all of my platforms at one time, right? I have them all open up, and I open up the trade window, right? And then so I set up hotkeys for the buy button, for the sell button, for the flat button. And then I have other things in there. I have a pretty, complicated system to where I have a lot of moving pieces. But basically, what I'm doing is I'm just using the hotkey, and I'm pressing the hotkey so that the mouse presses on each. Let's say I'm trying to get into a trade, I'm trying to buy. So when I press my hotkey to buy, the mouse will automatically click on all the buy buttons on all the trade windows that I have opened up that I've set this thing up for, right? So getting back to setting this up, I don't really use this part of it. For me, I didn't find it to be the best way to get the functionality that I need. So what I do is I come down here to this little A, and I click on that. that will bring up this window right here to where I can start configuring this thing, right? And so you can see I have several actions configured in here, and depending on what I want to do, right? So let me go ahead and minimize this, and I can illustrate this a little bit better. And once you have this up, you can actually close this and it should still work. All right, so what you'll do is you want to set up an action for every mouse click that you want, right? And let's just say, for instance, I'm trying to get this out of the way. Let's just say, for instance, I want to set up, when I hit the buy hotkey, I want it to hit the buy market on both of these trade windows. So what I will do is I will go in here, and I'm just going to set these up as a test, and I'm going to delete it. I already have all this set up. I'm going to just show you how to set this up, but I'm not going to save what I do, right? I'm just going to show you how to do it, and then I will show you how it works based off of what I already have set up. So what you'll do is, when you want to set up one of these hotkeys, is you'll go in and you can just right click, or you can go up here to the menu and you will click on new mouse action. There's different things you can do, of course, but let's just stay focused on what we're trying to do here. So you click on new mouse action, and then I want to do a left click. So I'm gonna leave that at left click, and I'm gonna go to at fixed location on the screen. And then what I'll do is I'll hit pick, and that's, for that example, we're going to do buy market, right? And then you can see the coordinates of what that is where you just selected. And you can also test it in a way to see where your mouse is going to click by clicking the show. And you'll see that the mouse jumped over here to the buy market button, right? And then you can name it. I'm just going to name this one buy market test, right? And then what you'll do is you go ahead and click OK. You're not done yet, so then you'll go back into it. And the first thing you want to make sure you do is configure this auto stop. This is like the most important piece of it. You want to go configure this auto stop, and you want to change that from 0 to 1. Sometimes if it doesn't work, you may need to change it to 2, but you want it at 1. So the reason why this is so important, if you have it set at 0, what it'll do is it will keep clicking it until you break that sequence. So, and it can be hard to break it. I've accidentally, been playing around with this and forgot to change that setting, and I've had to restart my whole computer because it just kept doing it and I couldn't stop it, right? So that can be an issue if you don't change that. So make sure before you start trading in these actual evaluations over real money or with the funded side of these programs, that you test this out in SIM first. Test it in SIM first, make sure everything works and that you have everything set up correctly, because you don't want to make any unnecessary mistakes with this. This can be costly if you mess this up, right? So now that you got your auto stop set at 1, you can see that over here, to make sure over here on the right that you have it set to 1, you're going to go back into it, and now you're going to set up the shortcut or the hotkey, the keyboard shortcut or the hotkey, by going to assign keyboard shortcut. And then let's say for this, let's just say I want it to be, Alt M, right? You just press that in there. I wonder if you can, I haven't tried doing like something like, let's see if I can do a Control Alt M. Click inside of the box. Oh, so you can. All right, so you can set your hotkey to whatever you want it to be, and you just set your hotkey that way and you click OK. So like I said before, I'm just showing you how to set this up. I'm actually going to remove this one because I don't want to actually use this. I don't want to keep it there. And if you want to remove one, you just go to delete selected actions, highlight on it, and it'll open up this confirmation window here. Just go ahead and click yes. You can make sure delete the selected one action and then go ahead and do yes. And so, all right, so this is how I have mine set up for now. I'm gonna go ahead and minimize this, and we're gonna run through an example. So let me go ahead and open up a replay mode so we can run through this example, and then I can show you how I have this set up. All right, so now that we have replay mode set up so that I can, run through this, show an example of how this will work with my current configuration. And I have to do it like this because this is a weekend, and of course the futures market is not open. All right, so with this, now the way that I have this set up is I don't use my keyboard for the hotkeys. I actually use a Stream Deck. And I should insert a picture somewhere in here of my Stream Deck set up the way that it is right now. That's another video for another day. I just wanted to make this about Mergi. You can use a keyboard, or you can use something like a Stream Deck or anything like that. to make it as simple and as easy for you as you want to make it. All right, so let's just say, for instance, let's just say I want to take a position long. All I'm going to do is I'm going to hit my buy hotkey that I set up in Mergi. So I just press it. And then, so what I want you to do with this is pay attention to my trade windows here. Matter of fact, I'm going to do a bigger one than that. So pay attention to my trade windows here. And here you'll see how this works. And you can see my mouse right there, right? I'm going to take my hand off the mouse and I'm just going to hit my mouse, my buy button to execute a trade. Now, actually, you can see what that did. That was wonderful. That was beautiful. I didn't even try to do that like that. So now you can see this little you can see this little blue dot. That's where it clicked, right? And there's other screens that I have set up, my other monitor. So I have three different platforms that I use, right? And you know, if I switch over this screen, you can also see the little blue dots. I hope you can see that. You can see the little blue dots. You see there's one there, there's one there, and then there's another one there. So every time I click on that button, so now I'm gonna go with, let's say I want to close that position out. We're gonna use pink for the, well, I don't know how well pink is gonna show up. Let me use red. And let's just say I want to close that out. So now you can see where the red clicked, where that closeout would have been if I were to close that position out. You see this little red right there. Going back to the other monitor, you can see the little red right there on my flatten button. So that's basically how it works. And so now that we, you know, you can see it like that. I mean, actually, I'm going to show you, we can run through it and we can see it actually work in this replay mode. That was one of those mistakes that turned out to be a good thing. Let me go ahead and set my mouse back here. And then, so let me do that action again. I'm gonna hit buy. So you see it puts me in a position, long. And you know, for this example, let's just say I'm gonna hit reverse. I already got reverse set up. You can set this however you wanna set it up. And you see I can do that. Let's just say I changed my position size. And let's just say, let me add to it on that position size. And the way I also have it set up, if I want to go back to my main position size, I have a hotkey set up that you can see it put me back at my main, or at the main position size that I'm taking my one lot off of, right? So, and then let's go ahead and close out this position. I hit the flat button and now I'm closed out. And that's how I have my system set up. And it does this across everywhere. It does this everywhere that I tell this auto mouse click software to click on the screen when I press a certain hotkey. Okay. Now, the one thing that you do want to make sure that you're aware of when you're using this system is if you're using a VM also, you got to make sure your mouse is not inside of that VM, because that has messed me up several times to where I was maybe trying to take a trade or in a trade and trying to take profit, and my mouse was inside the VM. So when I hit the hotkey, nothing happened. So I just had to, you know, move my mouse outside of the VM and then click back on the screen on my regular, you know, computer screen. And then I was able to close the position. You know, luckily most of the time that happened, I was still able to get out pretty much, if not where I wanted to get out, close to where I wanted to get out. All right. So once you're done trading for the day, definitely you want to make sure that you close down your Mergi. You want to close down the software, because you don't want to hit a hotkey and end up clicking your mouse in a random when you're not, you know, actually using the system the way that you have it designed to use. So just close it down, close it up for the day. And then when you're ready to trade again, you can put it in your checklist to make sure that you have your trade copier open, just like I do. You can see in my journal, my online journal, I have this checklist here. I have it here to check off that I open my trade copier and then the appropriate chart windows, right? So I got to check that off every single day before I get started trading. That makes sure that I have it open and it's ready for me to use, and I'm ready to go once my session starts, right? So that's all I really wanted to, you know, show you in this video. If you have any questions or anything like that, just go ahead and leave those in the comment section below. If you found this helpful, you know, go ahead and let me know by hitting the like button. That way I know that I'm making content that you want to see, because I'm here for you, not just for myself. If I was just here for myself, I'd just keep all this information to myself and all of that good stuff. All right. So go ahead and let me know what you think in the comment section below. Any questions? And I will see you on the next one. Trade it easy.